In this video, we will discuss about what is continuity equation in fluid mechanics. The continuity equation states that in the case of steady flow, the amount of fluid flowing past one point must be the same as the amount of fluid flowing past another point, or the mass flow rate is constant. It is essential statement for law of conservation of mass. Now consider the fluid flows for a short interval of time in the tube. So assume that as delta t. In this time, the fluid will cover a distance of delta x1 with a velocity v1 at the lower end of pipe. And we know that distance equal to speed into time. Therefore, delta x1 equal to v1 into delta t. Now at the lower end of pipe, the volume of fluid that will flow into the pipe will be indicated by capital V. Therefore, capital V equal to area A1 into delta x1, where delta x1 we have already formulated as V1 into delta t. So I will substitute this value. And we know that mass equal to density into volume. Therefore, mass equal to in region delta x1 will be delta m1 equal to rho 1 into volume of fluid that will flow into the pipe, where in equation we have formulated volume of fluid as a1 v1 delta t. So I substitute this. Now we have to calculate the mass flux at lower part of pipe, and mass flux is defined as mass of fluid per unit time passing through any cross sectional area. Therefore, mass flux for lower end of pipe, that is delta m1 upon delta t, will be equal to rho 1 into a1 v1. Similarly, mass flux at upper end of pipe, which is delta m2 upon delta t, will be equal to rho 2 into a2 v2. Here v2 is velocity of fluid flowing in upper end of pipe and delta t is time. A2 is area of cross section of upper end of pipe. Now in this pipe, the density of fluid between lower end of pipe, that is rho 1, and upper end of pipe, that is rho 2, remains the same with time as the fluid flow is steady. So the mass flux at lower end of pipe equal to the mass flux at upper end of pipe, that is equation 3 equal to equation 4. Thus rho 1 into a1 v1 equal to rho 2 into a2 v2. Thus equation 5 can be written as a1 v1 equal to a2 v2. Now this equation can be written in general form as av equal to constant. So this was the derivation of continuity equation.